The inspiration for this collection sort of started for me a few years ago when I was initially looking at renting a house in the city. And went around and looked at a bunch of different places, and I started to notice they're all very much the same sort of cookie-cutter design, with like this little tiny living room where you just had enough room for like a couch and a little TV adjacent to the kitchen. That's kind of what it was. And, as I saw more and more of them, and I realized they were all the same, I could tell quite obviously they were designed, they had no basement, they were all ground-level suites, and ostensibly kind of nice because they were new, but they were so fabricated and cookie cutter, they almost put me off. And then I realized that as I kept seeing them, that these must be the new Vancouver Special. This must be what the Vancouver Special is in 2009. None of these houses will actually be seen next to each other in reality. They're all from different places in the city and combined together. So every house is photographed separately. It was definitely a lot of time to sort of put them together. But the idea was to sort of create this sort of forced perspective. So I really like the flattened perspective because it really reduces the structures to symbols and gives it that sort of hazy, you know, you see this reality first, maybe you don't pick up that it's not actually possible that things could look that way. So at least in sort of this dreamy space where it becomes more about how we remember the city, the ideas we have in the city and our thoughts about it, than sort of that strict sort of documentary look that you would get from just a straight up photograph. After sort of starting with the Vancouver Specials and the new ones, I started looking for other stories just in the architecture of the city, just the way the buildings look and other narratives that can be found in the structures that we build. And you know, that sort of went from there on to seeing the storybook houses on the west side versus those sort of very almost spooky looking Victorian Edwardian ones you see on the east side, and how that plays up that narrative of sort of the sketchy east side versus the posh west side, right? Which in reality now all those houses are $1 million anyway, but it's funny how we still have those stories, right? And so I started looking for other stories. So there's Davies Orchard is another one. I found these cabins that, you know, there was a whole preservation society came up to sort of protect these cabins from being knocked down. And with the old entertainment district, I call it the Granville Street one you mentioned, that's what Granville Street used to look like. It used to have all those seedy adult video stores, and then, of course, prior to the Olympics, the city moved those all out, moved all the clubs down onto Granville Street. And so it's just another way we can tell the story about how the city is changing and how, you know, events happening in the city make a change and how there's always money behind all of these decisions. In some ways it's sort of a love letter to the city, like the Vancouver Specials with the mountains in the background. It's done in a way that's almost idyllic, and I do love the city and I do want people to take that from it. But at the same time, when you love something that you have an adult relationship with, there's also room to sort of be critical of it, and I think that's really important as well. So, you know, as much as I love the city, it has problems, and maybe some of the ways that things are happening or some of the decisions we're making or maybe your politicians are making aren't necessarily the best for preserving our heritage. So the show is up here at Hot Art Wood City from January 7th to 30th. The opening is tonight, that is January the 8th, Friday night at 7 p.m. So please come on down, take a look. I will be here, and I look forward to seeing you all there.